Hey guys, today I'm going to teach you how to play Tattoo by Hunter Hayes. This is a really great summery song and it's also really nice and simple to play, so hopefully it will sound great. First things first, you'll need a capo on the 3rd fret and you'll need to know how to play the chords C, A minor, F, G and D minor. If you know how to play those, then you can skip ahead, and if you don't, I will show you how to play them now. Here we go. Okay, so our C is the first finger on the 1st fret 2nd string, our 2nd finger on the 2nd fret 3rd string, 4th string, and our 3rd finger on the 3rd fret 5th string, and that sounds like this. The F I'm going to play as a bar chord, but alternatively you could just put your 2nd finger on the 2nd fret 3rd string and your 3rd finger on the 3rd fret 4th string and play it like the same way as you played the C with that first finger on the 1st fret 2nd string. Or you can play it as the bar chord, which is what I'm going to do, which is your 1st finger on the 1st fret covering all of the strings, your 2nd finger on the 2nd fret on the 3rd string, your 3rd finger on the 3rd fret 5th string, and your 4th finger on the 3rd fret 4th string, and that sounds like this. Then there's the G, which is your 1st finger on the 2nd fret 5th string, your 2nd finger on the 3rd fret 6th string, your 3rd finger on the 3rd fret 2nd string, and your 4th finger on the 3rd fret 1st string, and that sounds like this. You've got the A minor, which is your 1st finger on the 1st fret 2nd string, your 2nd finger on the 2nd fret 4th string, and your 3rd finger on the 2nd fret 3rd string, and that sounds like this. And then lastly, there's the D minor, which is your 1st finger on the 1st fret 1st string, your 2nd finger on the 2nd fret 3rd string, and your 3rd finger on the 3rd fret 2nd string, and that sounds like this. And those are the chords. This song is nice and easy because the chord pattern pretty much repeats throughout the whole song, which makes it really simple to remember. So for the introduction, you're going to play C, F, G, A minor, and you're going to repeat that twice. For strumming, you can do a whole host of different things. It's really up to you. You should, however, use a combination of downward and upward strokes, focusing mainly on down strokes. And I pretty much do like a 2-to-1 ratio, so if I stroke the strings downward twice, I'll do them up once. But you don't have to stick to that, that's just the way that I like to do it. You can also add in some palm mutes, which is when you use this part of your hand to stop the strings. So I'll kind of play through both of those kind of options that I like the best, I guess. So this is the one without the palm mutes, so it goes C, F, G, A minor, C, F, G, A minor. And then there's the other one, which is with the palm mutes, so that goes C, F, G, A minor, C, F, G, A minor. Either way, you're going to play that chord pattern through C, F, G, A minor, and you're going to play it through twice. Then you've got your first verse, so that's going to be the same chord patterns, C, F, G, A minor. You're going to play that through twice again, then you're going to play D minor, and then you're going to play G. And for the first verse is kind of twice the length of the second verse, so you're going to repeat that pattern another time, so C, F, G, A minor twice, then D minor, then G. So I will play that through for you. It's going to repeat the same strumming pattern as you used for the introduction. I'm really bad at singing, but I'll just sing the lyrics over the top of that so that you kind of get an idea of how that will sound to the song. So excuse this really bad rendition, here it goes. I could spray paint all of you on that glittering sky, and I could swear when you say it to me there's a good chance I could fly, and I might, it seems like it, it's gonna be any night, it's worth beating night. And then you repeat it again. Yeah, that was pretty bad. So the chorus is C, F, G, A minor, C, F, G, A minor, C, F, G, A minor, F, G, and then C, F, G, A minor another 2 times. So nice and simple, C, F, G, A minor 3 times, F, G, then C, F, T, A minor, another two times. And I will play it through to you, all the way through, just so that you get an idea. It goes C, F, G. And at the cafe, I'm gonna put it in on my lips, baby. F, G, A minor, F, G, C, G, A minor, C, F, G, A minor. Sorry if I surprised you with that singing halfway through. I realised that you might want the timings again. So yeah, that's how you play that. Then you've got another verse, which isn't quite the same as the first verse, actually. So what you do is C, F, G, A minor, same as usual. Then there's the D minor, and then there's the G. For this verse, I think you play the D minor and the G for a little bit longer than you did in that first verse. And also, you don't repeat the pattern again, it stops. So you just play that through once before you get to your next chorus, which is the same as the first chorus, so that's something that doesn't change. Then you've got the bridge. So for the bridge, what you actually do is play C, F, G, A minor, C, F, D minor. And I will play it through to you. It doesn't sound like a lot like the rest of the song. You're doing quite fast transitions through each chord. So it'll go C, F, F, and then he sings the line, and then it's going to go G, A minor, sings the line, and then another C, F, and this is when it goes, and it looks like I found it, I found D minor, I literally found it, girls. And then you just strum that D minor like that, whilst the singing carries on, and then it goes back into another chorus, which is the same as the other choruses. So things I will apologise for are the bad singing and a couple of mistakes I made in that. Sorry, I hope it didn't make it too confusing for you guys to watch. Other than that, I hope this helped you, and thank you for watching.